The ventilatory threshold is a critical physiological marker that occurs during exercise when the rate of carbon dioxide production surpasses the rate of oxygen consumption. This threshold is essential in assessing an individual's aerobic fitness and performance capabilities, and it helps in determining optimal training intensities for endurance athletes. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. There are two distinct ventilatory thresholds that can be identified during incremental exercise, VT1 and VT2. The first ventilatory threshold, or VT1, is also known as the aerobic threshold, and it marks the point at which the body starts to rely more on anaerobic metabolism to meet the energy demands of exercise. This shift occurs when lactic acid starts to accumulate in the bloodstream faster than it can be cleared, causing an increase in carbon dioxide production. At this threshold, ventilation becomes slightly disproportionate to the amount of oxygen being consumed, leading to an increased respiratory rate. And then you have the second ventilatory threshold, or VT2, and it is also known as the anaerobic threshold. This is the point at which the reliance on anaerobic metabolism becomes more pronounced. At this stage, lactic acid accumulates rapidly, and the body can no longer maintain a steady state of exercise. This leads to a significant increase in carbon dioxide production, which triggers a marked increase in ventilation to expel the excess carbon dioxide. Exercise intensity at VT2 is considered very high, and it can only be sustained for a short period of time. Various methods can be employed to measure the ventilatory threshold, including gas exchange measurements, lactate analysis, and the ventilatory equivalent method. Gas exchange measurements involve monitoring the rates of oxygen consumption and carbon dioxide production during an incremental exercise test, typically performed on a treadmill or a cycle ergometer. Lactate analysis involves measuring blood lactate concentrations at different exercise intensities to determine the points where lactate accumulation begins to rise significantly. The ventilatory equivalent method involves monitoring the ventilatory equivalent for oxygen and carbon dioxide and identifying breakpoints or deflections in the plotted data. Understanding an individual's ventilatory threshold is crucial for optimizing training programs, particularly for endurance athletes. By training at intensities near or between these thresholds, athletes can improve their aerobic and anaerobic capacities, allowing them to perform at higher intensities for more extended periods of time. Additionally, the ventilatory threshold serves as an indicator of an individual's overall fitness level and can be used to monitor the effectiveness of a training program. So, just to give a quick recap, the ventilatory threshold is a vital physiological concept that provides valuable information about an individual's metabolic response to exercise. Identifying and understanding these thresholds is crucial for optimizing training programs and assessing athletic performance. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.